Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today's CPA topic of the day is going to be on not-for-profit organizations' financial statements. So if you're like me and you're studying for the CPA exam, hit subscribe to my channel. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. So let's get into it. So they have three basic statements. They have cash flows, activities, which is kind of like an income statement and retained earnings combined, and a financial position, which is a balance sheet. So your statement of financial position has a section that specifies the amount of net assets with or without donor restrictions. So what's a donor restriction? A donor restriction is when a donor contributes money but says, oh, you can only use it for this specific thing. The reason that it's separated out is because we don't want to show that we have a bunch of net worth that we can't actually freely use. So your statement of activities has two separate columns and then a total column. And each line specifies the amount of funds that are donor restricted, not donor restricted, and then you have that total. Then your statement of cash flows, in the normal operating activity section, they have revenue earned with or without donor restrictions. And then in the financing activity section, you have donor restricted proceeds from contributions listed separately.